Hello guys, and welcome to Delicate Flavors with Pallavi. Today we are going to make the quintessential lunch essential. Yes, the very famous aloo gobi with a small twist in my way, my style. Let's start making aloo gobi my way, my style.
Piping hot, delicious looking aloo gobi sabzi is ready. For making aloo gobi, what I have taken is I have taken cauliflower and cut it into a little big size florets, and I have taken potatoes and I have cut it like this, peeled off the potatoes. Cauliflower I have taken 250 grams, potatoes I have taken 150 grams, so together it is 450 grams. The first step is blanching of the vegetables, so I have kept some water for boiling, into which I am going to add half a spoon of salt, and I am going to add all the vegetables and let them blanch for 5 minutes. Also, I will cover it and keep it. So we will take a look at the vegetables after 5 minutes. It is 5 minutes that the vegetables are boiling. Let us just take a look. This is enough. I will turn off the flame here and drain off excess water, and then start with the preparation of our sabzi. Now to start the recipe of aloo gobi, what I have taken is I have taken some oil, 2 big spoons of oil. The kadhai is already preheated and I am putting in the vegetables, of which I have removed the excess water. Let us stir fry the vegetables until they develop a brown coating. You see here that the vegetables have started to develop a brown coat. We need them to be more brown. At this moment, what I will do is I will also add 1 large onion, very finely chopped, and 2 slit green chilies. So they will all brown together. The onions have gotten brown. Now I will add 1/2 inch of ginger, crushed finely, 6 cloves of garlic, finely crushed. Give it a nice mix. Mix them until the raw flavors of the ginger and onion disappear. The ginger and garlic is cooked well. I am adding 1 big tomato, very finely chopped. Mix this all well. I will cover it for 2 minutes until the tomatoes are done. It is 2 minutes and let us take a check on the sabzi. Yes, the tomatoes seem to be well cooked. Now here at this point we will start adding all our spices. First I am taking 1/2 spoon of garam masala, 1 spoon of salt, you can take salt to your taste, 1/2 spoon of turmeric powder, 2 spoons of Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 spoon of cumin powder, 1/2 spoon of coriander powder. Now that we have added all our spices, we will give it a nice mix. The vegetables are already well cooked. Now here we will add in the last ingredient, which is 1/2 cup of curd. I have just slightly beaten up the curd. Mix it nicely. At this point I will just add few crystals of sugar so as to balance the sourness of curd and the tomatoes in the vegetable, and we will stir it now until the curd cooks very well. Keep the flame on the low so as the curd will not split. Here at this point the curd is well cooked, the vegetables are also very nicely done. What I will do is I'll add 1/2 glass of water here. You can add water to your desire. Give it a quick stir. I'll increase the flame here and allow it to come to a boil. Our sabzi here has come to a nice boil. I add the last ingredient, which is kasuri methi, and I will close the lid. Let the flame be at the lowest and we will cook for another 2 minutes. It is 2 minutes. Let us just take a look at the sabzi. Yes, it is nice and sizzling. I'll just give it a quick stir. Consistency of the sabzi here for me is enough. You can adjust the consistency to your choice. I'll turn off the flame here and give it a standing time of 10 minutes and then serve it. I will serve the sizzling hot sabzi now. Our steaming hot alu gobi sabzi is ready.
The twist of adding curd in alu gobi, I hope you have liked it. It takes the recipe to a next level altogether. Do try this and let me know in the comments how you have liked your vegetable this afternoon. So by the time I see you next time, please subscribe to my channel, give it a big, big like, share it with your friends and family. And by the time I come back with a brand new episode, bye for now.